Hey, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we're going to learn to measure to the half and quarter inch. Let's go. In our lesson so far, we've been measuring the lengths and heights of objects to the whole inch. Let's take a look at this red line. How long is it? We can see that it lines up with 7 inches. In fact, it lines up perfectly with 7 inches. This means that the line is 7 whole inches. But what if it wasn't lined up perfectly with 7 inches? What if instead our red line ended somewhere between 7 inches and 8 inches? In this lesson, we're going to learn how to measure things that are between whole inches. Let's start with inches. I've zoomed way in our ruler here, so we only see the first 3 inches. Let's talk about what an inch is. This blue rectangle is 1 whole inch. In the United States, an inch is the smallest unit of measurement for length and height. But we know that there could be a rectangle that is smaller than 1 whole inch. Like this red rectangle. If we want to measure something that is smaller than an inch, we have to divide the inch into parts. Let's use our blue rectangle to help us see. Remember, we measured our blue rectangle to be exactly 1 whole inch. Now, if we draw a line right down the middle of our rectangle, what do we get? Well, now we have 2 rectangles that are each 1/2 inch. So we see that we can divide an inch into 2 parts that each equal 1/2 inch. Now what if we draw a line right down the middle of both of the 1/2 rectangles? Now we have 4 rectangles. Now using what we know about fractions, if we take one thing and divide it into 4 parts, each part is 1/4. This shows us that we can divide 1 whole inch into 4 parts, and each part will be 1/4, or 1/4 of an inch. Now let's take a look at the ruler again. Do you notice anything about the marks on the ruler? Yeah, these big lines here represent 1 whole inch. And then we see these 3 smaller lines in between. What do you think that this longer line in the middle represents? Well, if we compare the distance from the taller middle line to the whole inch lines, it appears to be right in the middle. So this is the 1/2 inch mark. And these shorter lines are cutting halfway between the 1/2 inch mark, so they must be the 1/4 inch marks. Let's zoom in now between the 1 and 2 inch marks and do a quick fraction review. Remember, each of these distances is 1/4. So if we're going to count them, we would have 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, before we would come to the next whole number. And we can simplify 2/4 to what? Yeah, that's right, 1/2. Now that we know how to divide an inch into parts, let's measure the length of this green line. So if it starts here at the edge of the inch mark, and it goes 1/4, 1/2, 3/4 across the inch, this green line is 3/4 of an inch. Let's do a few examples now without our extra markings. What is the length of this rectangle? It starts at 0 and it goes past the 3 whole inch mark. But by how much? Well, let's count. We have 3 1/4, 3 2/4, and 3 2/4 is the same as 3 1/2. So this rectangle is 3 1/2 inches long. How about this one? It's longer than the 4 whole inch mark and goes to the first marker, which we know is 1/4. So this rectangle is 4 1/4 inches long. Now let's take a quick look at our original ruler and find the 1/2 inch and 1/4 inch marks. We can zoom in to make it easier to see. Now notice between the 1 inch and the 2 inch marks, we have all these little lines. Let's count how many longer lines there are. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 1 would make 8. So the halfway point would be at line 4. If this is the halfway point between 1 inch and 2 inches, we know that this is the half inch mark. And if we cut our half inch in half, we find the quarter inches here and here. Now, using our ruler, let's measure this yellow rectangle. I see that it lands between 1 inch and 2 inch. And here's my quarter inch mark, and my half inch mark, and my 3/4 inch mark. And the line ends right here, so this rectangle is 1 3/4 inches long. Now you know how to divide an inch into parts. Practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.